Maybe I'd be happy to let it all go and dedicate my life to making jelly molds. Learn to cook and learn to sew. I'm a happy homemaker.
Hi, and welcome to the Comfy Red Couch. My name is Tracy, and I'm your host. And I am coming to you from a beautiful, sunny, long weekend in Toronto. The sun is out. It is getting warm. I've shut the windows so that you don't hear all the extraneous noise from outside. I've even turned the fans off, so it might get a little bit warm in here. But I am happy to have you here, and I hope that you have a bit of time to just sit down, relax, and have a chance to see what I've been up to this week. If you would like to find me, I am Tracy RR on Ravelry, and I am at Comfy Red Couch on Instagram. If you're new to the podcast, this is a podcast that is primarily about knitting, although now that I'm on summer holiday, I am hoping to get a few more crafts done. Crossing fingers. Welcome, and I hope that you have a chance to just sit down, and I hope that you enjoy the podcast. If you are a returning viewer, you know I always love having you here, and I'm just so happy that you come back every week. And welcome back. I hope you have your spot on the comfy red couch. I know that you have settled in with your project of choice, and that you also have your beverage of choice. And that is now going to lead us into tea time, which is kind of not tea time for me today. It's going to be something I very, very rarely drink. It's going to be coffee time. And I am drinking a cup of coffee loaded with cream and sugar because that's the only way I can take coffee. And this is my Tim Hortons mug. Beavers Campy. It's just a very campy mug and very foresty. So I am drinking coffee. I got myself a French press. I didn't just get it for me. I got it for Isaac and Greg because they actually do like to drink coffee. It's kind of weird having my 17-year-old drink coffee. But he's been drinking coffee. So I bought him a glass fresh French press a few weeks ago. And we were in the grocery store. I'll put that down for now. We were in the grocery store and we really like when we go to Disney World, they have the Kona Cafe and they do a lovely French press of their Kona coffee. And we were in the grocery store and they had some French presses, which were very reasonably priced. So we put it in the cart and he wants to take it to college with him in the fall. As I was pushing the cart out of the grocery store, there was a bit of a metal lip. And I hit the cart on the metal lip, and of course the French press is in the bag at the top and smashed down to the ground. So not even out of the store, and this thing smashed down to the ground. The grocery store was great. They replaced it, no issues. So I went back, got a new one, and have been carefully making sure that we look after the glass in that French press. So I have made some Kona Cafe from the Polynesian. We bought some, and I am having a cup of coffee today. So I am going to say cheers to the end of June, cheers to the beginning of July, and I am wishing you a wonderful, calm, relaxing week ahead. Cheers. I never drink coffee. French press coffee is always, always so much better. I might become a coffee addict. It's possible. There's something really nice about French pressed coffee. I'm not sure if I'm ready to take on the French press coffee every day, but I really do love my tea a lot more. But sometimes every once in a while, I like a nice cup of coffee. So that's today. Okay, so let us get on with the things that I have been working on this week. And I've been working on a few different things. First off, I have been working on the project that lives in this surfer bag. And this is a secret test knit, but I have shared the yarn with you. And oh, the yarn. The yarn is just so, so fun. This is Nora George Yarns, and this is Schools Out for Summer, S-U-M-M-A, of course. And it is just a fun, natural color with lots of specks of neon, as you can tell. And I am working away on this test knit. It is coming along very nicely. And now that I am on holiday, I am hoping that over the next week, I will get, if not completely finished, some really great progress done on this project. So that was a bit of a weird wording, but yes, I'm hoping to finish this project. So that is one project that I've been working on. The next project that came my way just a couple of days ago, and of course had to jump on my needles yesterday, my first official day of holiday, is in this gorgeous Bags by Awesome Granny bag, and this is the swans, and there's some water there. So this just happens to be the third shawl for the Shawl Society Season 4, and this will be released, I believe, July 18th. I'm loving it so far, and I was able to go a little bit into deep stash and use some yarn that's been in my stash for a little while. And you won't see this for another few weeks, but oh my goodness, it's going to be lovely. And I'm just about 20% now. I worked on it and I worked on this yesterday. So I sort of mixed my time up. So that is something that I will be working on. And I think it's going to be a relatively quick project as well. So I have every confidence that I will have it off the needles by the end of the week as well. I got back to a project that I love and that I haven't spent time with in quite a while. And this is a project that is living in my lovely So Sweet Violet flamingo bag with the sparkly stars. And this is my sky map, wrap, which I am using Gorgeous Cosmic. This is the colorway Cosmic on Viola Mohair. And oh my goodness, these are getting low. I'll soon be bringing in the next skeins. So this is my sky map, and it is just so wide, so corner to corner, it's going to be a very, very wide shawl. I'm starting to worry a little bit about the length. I'm not sure whether I might need some more skeins of Cosmic. I do have my marker here. So the last time I picked this project up, I had put the marker there, and I am now about an inch farther along. So not a lot of work done on this, but Friday, as soon as I finished work, I decided that I wanted to go up to the knitting loft and just sit and knit and have a lovely cup of tea. And I decided the best project to bring with me was my sky map because it's just an easy knit. It was a little bit of a juggle with the two alternating skeins, but it was just so nice to sit down, have lovely chatter with the people who were sitting there as well and knitting away, and a lovely cup of tea. And there were some amazing chocolates that were there as well. And yes, I got a little tiny bit of progress done on my sky map. And this is a pattern by Emily Foden, who is the dyer behind Viola Yarns. And this was in last year's Pom Pom Quarterly, the Moon Edition. So a very, very simple pattern. And at some point, once I have all of it off the needles, I will then do the embroidery bit, which then takes this big circle and sews it together, making just the most lush wrap. So this is such a happy, happy, calming project, and just it's fun to work with the mohair. It just really is. So it was really fantastic to do just a little bit of work, but some work on my gorgeous sky map. And it's always fun bringing out this project bag. The final project that I am going to share with you. So four projects this week, that's not bad. Little bits here and there. This is the one I spent most of my time on. And it is now off the needles. I got it off the needles late on Wednesday. I had an event at work on Thursday, so I worked and then I rushed home and I had about a 2-hour window, got the inkling blocked, and then went back to work for the event. And then when I came back, it was just so hot that the inkling was dry, so I was able to take it off the needles. And on Friday morning, I took a few photographs. I haven't quite got the photograph that I was hoping for. So this is the yarn that I used for my second inkling, and they are all La Bien Aimée yarns. And three of them are the singles, and the fourth is the mohair. So color A is High Garden, and it is this gorgeous pink. And I had it out in the daylight the other day, and the color shifts to almost a peachy color, which is interesting. I hadn't seen it that way before. So High Garden. Color B is the mohair, and this is the mohair silk, La Bien Aimée, and this is the colorway Curious Handmade. And oh my goodness, it was just so lovely to work with. And all little pops of color that come out as you're knitting, oh, amazing. And color C, again, we're back to Merino Singles, is Curious Handmade. Love, love, love. And this was a much bigger ball of yarn last week. This is Emmeline, and again on singles, and it's this gorgeous, gorgeous green. Hello, Tasha. Have you come to say hello? You want to see the inkling? So that is all the yarn that I have left. I still need to weigh it. I know it's not that hard to weigh it, but I need to weigh it and put those numbers on my Ravelry page. So I will get to that hopefully this afternoon. So, the inkling. Another, oh my goodness, this is a monster. This is a monster. It's huge, but it is so, so beautiful. So it is hard to hold up to share with you in its full glory. So unfortunately here, I'm gonna sit back on the cat a little bit. And of course I want her to stay away from the inkling, and I definitely want to keep the inkling away from the coffee that's on the table in front of me. So this is the inkling. It starts off with this gorgeous, I have a cat on my lap. It starts off with this gorgeous center flower in the middle, and then all these petals radiate outwards. So there's no real great way to do this. So beautiful center flower, and oh, too hard. It's too hard to do a really great show of this shawl. So in the center is this gorgeous, gorgeous flower. Look at those petals. And then we go out and it radiates into more beautiful petals, and we're alternating our colors with the mohair and just continues into this absolutely glorious, glorious shawl. And I'm going to try and find, and of course the camera never really catches it properly. I am going to try, there we go, I think there's a little bit there. I don't think the camera's going to catch it though. But where the Curious Handmade mohair is, just those little bits there, so I think a little bit of purple in there, there's little bits of yellow, and it just, outside especially, captures the light. And there's a cat who has claws that is putting her paws closer to the inkling, which is not definitely not a good thing. But this is the amazing Inkling shawl. This is very close to the original colors. They're not quite the original colors that Helen used. She used a different pink, and I'm trying to remember what the name of the pink was. So I have High Garden, and I'm going to have to put down what Helen's original colors were. I do know that where I used Emmeline, which is more of a green, she used Winterfell, which is more of a very dark blue, a very rich blue. The green comes out absolutely lovely. And of course, the Curious Handmade mohair and the Curious Handmade singles were the same as well. So the pink and the edging were a little different. Hers is, of course, pink as well. At some point, I will remember the name. It will probably be 2 a.m. because that's what happens. But it's going to be before then because I'm going to pop up which colors Helen used. And again, I used High Garden, Curious Handmade in the mohair silk, and also the merino singles, and then Emmeline. So that is the gorgeous, gorgeous Inkling shawl, halved and now quartered and folded up again. So this is going to be a gift. I was sent the yarn to create, and I will be sending this to a very, very special someone. So there is the Inkling, and oh, we might be able to see some of those gorgeous little bits of the mohair silk and the colorway just because I folded it on itself. But I just think that Inkling is absolutely amazing, and I don't think that it translates on camera or on video in the same way that it does in real life. In real life, the green really, I think, pulls it together and makes it well. When you see me holding up the colors, the green looks really quite stark against the rest of the colors, but when you see it all knit up and in person and with those gorgeous little shiny flecks of the mohair silk, it's just amazing. Anyway, that is what I've been up to. One thing that I want to share that I'm hoping to get up to this week is in my Grumpy Bear bag. And these are my lovely Mabel socks. And I have one done, and I finished this a while back. And I am hoping over the next week to, I don't know that I will finish with it within the week, but I really hope to at least get a good start on my second Mabel sock so that I can get these off the needles. I still need to decide whether I'm going to pull back and do the Mabel's cable in the middle of the cuff, which is what I should have done. I'll make that decision as I go along, depending how my fingers are feeling, I guess, from all knitting on that sock there. Anyway, Grumpy Bear will get a little bit of attention this week. And who else knows? I'm hoping to cast on Epoxy, and oh, I want to do all the knitting now that I'm on holiday, but I really need to just take it day by day and not overwhelm myself. Anyway, that is all I have for my favorite things, and I do have some things from Brown Paper Packages. It's now time for Brown Paper Packages, and I do have a few things to share with you. I picked some things up at the Knitting Loft on Friday afternoon when I went up there to do some knitting and tea, and I had an idea of what I wanted to do. Now, a couple of weeks ago, I bought this lovely skein of Miss Bim, and this is Ching Fibers. This is the Surrey silk, and oh my goodness, it's just so, so fluffy. And I was going to make a cowl for Isaac because he likes his cowls, and he's a very knit-worthy kid. But then I saw the My Chrysalis shawl, and I've seen it in real life as well. And I thought that maybe I would like to do a my chrysalis shawl. But then I showed it to Isaac, and Isaac said he would prefer a my chrysalis shawl over a cowl. So I went to the Knitting Loft and I bought a second skein of Miss Bim. And in order to do the my chrysalis, it's got some mohair in it and it mixes in a single. And this is a lovely skein of singles from Ching Fibers as well. And this is Sky Blue. And I'm just trying to find a little bit. When I was holding up different colors, this is the better skein, I think, to show it with. When I was holding up different colors with other yarns, this blue really popped nicely because there's little bits of blue in the Surrey Silk amid all of those crazy bright pinks, yellows, and of course with the black. So that is going to be a project that I'm going to work on for Isaac. I'm not sure whether I will have it done by the end of the summer to send with him to college, or whether it will have to wait until his birthday, because his birthday is in October. So Thanksgiving, Canada Thanksgiving, I would then have it ready for him, which is when it starts getting cooler anyway. But oh, yes, that's going to be fun. So I still need to get the pattern. And then this is going to be a My Chrysalis shawl. So that's one of the things that I went and picked up this week because there was a change in plan. But then I also had some lovely packages that, well, it was one lovely package that arrived in the mail, and it was filled with lots and lots of yarny goodness. So a few weeks ago, I saw that this colorway, and this is Damoiselle Dragonfly. This is Nora George Yarns on Super Sock. And I just saw this color and I thought, this would be a lovely, lovely sweater. I think it's the Sparkle Cardigan is something I was thinking of. And that's a pattern by Hohe Locatelli. That's one I was thinking that I might knit these up into. I'm not 100% sure now though. So anyway, this gorgeous teals with little speckles. It's going to be a sweater of some sort. So that is one of the lovely things that arrived in my mailbox. And along with the Damoiselle Dragonfly, I have some spoiler alert. So spoiler alert, spoiler alert. I have some Mrs. Weasley's Clubs, and I have the Sock Club. And I have the Shawl Club as well. So if you do not want to see the Sock Club or the Shawl Club, cover your eyes, cover your ears, run screaming out of the room, do what you need to do. But I will tell you, Tracy shared the Shawl Club on her Instagram, so you may have seen it anyway, so you may just want to stick around. Anyway, spoiler alert, just in case. So let us start off with the one that Tracy spoiled on her Instagram page, and this is the Shawl Club. So this is the Summer Shawl Club, and it is 80% superwash merino with 20% silk. So the first color is this gorgeous, gorgeous gray. It doesn't have a name other than the Summer Shawl Club, and it is paired with this other merino silk blend in this gorgeous, gorgeous pink. And the third color that goes with it is another Surrey Silk. And oh my goodness, aren't these just so, so lovely together? And I'm not sure what I'm going to make with them, but oh my goodness, this color. It's like a little thing of cotton candy, but not quite as like a cotton candy you'd want to eat rather than a nuclear pink cotton candy. Oh, love, love. So that is the Summer Shawl Society, not the Summer Shawl Society, the Summer Mrs. Weasley's Shawl Club, and not sure what I'm going to make with it, but when I do, it's going to be lovely. Just those colors together are amazing. And the final spoiler is the Mrs. Weasley's Sock Club, and this one is called Sunset at the Burl, and just fun beachy colors. I think these may need to go to Cape Cod with me to make a pair of socks. So Sunset at the Burl is this color here, and of course there was a gorgeous mini that goes along with it. So look at the pink and purple. I'm wondering if that's going to self-stripe, but yes, I think this may need to go to Cape Cod with me and make a lovely pair of summer socks. Just some plain vanillas, maybe. Something simple that I can do on the beach while I'm avoiding sharks, because I'm not going near the water. Well, I'll go near the water, but I'm not going past, like, my knees. No. There have been lots of shark sightings, but there's just so many reasons to stay on the shore. Two needles worth. Knitting, knitting, knitting. Anyway, that is Sunset at the Burl, and this is Tracy's Super Sock, which I absolutely love working with, and yeah, that'll be a really great pair of socks to just relax, knit, and enjoy some sunshine. So that leaves me with an empty basket. It was a busy week on brown paper packages, I'd say at least. It's now time for Bits and Bobs, and this is my segment where I talk about anything and everything not necessarily knitting related. And Tasha has decided that she would like to come a little bit closer. Last night, I went to a store called Sage. Greg and I went out for supper, and I wanted to try and pick up a couple of things while we were at the local mall. And Sage has a new bug spray that I wanted to try out. It's Sage uses natural, like, aromatherapy type of essential oils, things like that. And I had read that they had a new bug spray. And a couple of weeks ago, we had been out at my parents' place. It's very, very buggy there. So this bug spray has lavender in it and something else, but it also has catnip. So they were all out of the bug spray, but they had the sample there. So I decided to spray some on my arms because I wanted to see whether I would like the smell. Like, you know, a couple hours in, do I like the smell? And I wanted to see whether there would be any reaction from Tasha. And so last night when we got home, I put my arm out and she started sniffing my arm. And you know how cats, when they've had catnip, do that little head roll thing? She started doing the head roll thing. So it might keep the bugs away, but you might get attached to cats. Okay, I didn't have a bath last night, so I think there's maybe still a faint linger of catnip on my arm. I think so. Is there catnip there? I think she's very, very happy. And you might see some more of those little head rolls happening. Anyway, I didn't get it. I don't know. We'll see. It wasn't crazy expensive, and I really, DEET and all of those bug sprays make me a little bit leery, so, but I don't know. Cat attack, bug attack. This cat's not so bad, but if we're out at my parents' place, my sister's cat is there for now, and that cat's a little bit, I don't know, might get a little bit crazy with some catnip, so mine just goes a little, and I can handle Tasha being like that. Anyway, that is something that happened last night. Oh, let's see. So Bits and Bobs, week behind. Isaac is now finished high school. He did not have a graduation ceremony this past week. It will happen in October. So I don't think it quite feels real for me yet. He has started his summer job and he's been picking up shifts throughout the week. he seems to enjoy it, although yesterday he had a long day shift. And when he came home, he was a little bit grumpy because I guess there were a lot of kids there. And he's in an indoor pool, and I guess people weren't quite listening. So he was a little bit frustrated when he got home. But he's picked up some more shifts, so he's quite happily lifeguarding. Cat is licking my arm like there's no tomorrow. Nathaniel has also finished school for the year, and he is going into grade 5 next year. So he was successfully promoted from grade 4 to grade 5, and he will have a teacher that Isaac did not get but has been there for a long time. And it's nice. I think he will enjoy his teacher next year as well. And his teacher's been there for a very long time, and every April, this teacher does crazy April Fool's tricks on the other teachers. So I think that Nathaniel will very much enjoy being in grade 5 with this wonderful teacher. He did have an amazing, amazing teacher this year who was a knitter. So I was really happy that he had that. I don't want to name names. So he had a good year. And I was very happy that he seemed happy in grade 4, which was great. Anyway, that is the kids. I am also on holiday now, and I don't think it's quite hit me. Yesterday I was just very overwhelmed, and I don't even know, just I think more numb than anything. It was a very, very busy year. The past couple of months have been emotional in many ways, but it's now time to move on. It's summer, and next year is looking a little bit different in my department, and I'm looking forward to going back. Not really. I want a holiday. I want a holiday. Let's be honest. I'm ready for summer vacation. And oh my goodness, all of the knitting plans that I have. I have so many, and I'm going to try to be realistic this year. Every summer, I think that I'm going to do this, that, and the other thing, and I might get this and the other thing done, but the this and the that just never do get done. So I am trying this year to be realistic. In the past couple of years, I have really pared down my travel knitting, where I used to take projects upon projects and think that I was going to get 6 different things done. One year, I took 6 skeins of turtle pearl, or 6 double skeins of turtle pearl, because it was the matching. I was sure I was going to get 6 pairs of socks done in 2 weeks. I got 1 pair done. And then I got bored. So, because you can't just work on the same project. So all that happened was I got 1 pair of socks done, and I had to make room for the remaining skeins coming home along with all of the camping equipment. And of course, a big, huge feeling of just, I can't do this kind of thing, you know, where you go thinking, I'm gonna get this done, and then you come home just feeling overwhelmed and guilty that you didn't get it done. There's no reason to feel guilty for not getting your knitting done, but that, you know, bit of that feeling where, you know, oh, what a waste. I wasted my time. I didn't waste my time. I had a really good time. But the problem is that I put too many expectations on myself. So the past couple of times we've gone away on holiday anywhere, I have really tried to lower my expectations. And I've taken 2, maybe 3 projects with me. So for example, when we went to Florida, I took the first inkling, which I wasn't going to take in the first place, but I ended up taking that, and I worked on it for a little bit. And I also took the socks with the Grim Grinning Ghost. And I really did such a great amount of work on the Grim Grinning Ghost socks, and I felt accomplished doing that. And And that was what I took. And if I wasn't working on one, I was working on the other, or I was actually having a nice holiday and spending time with my family. And my, I was thinking I had another project, but I didn't have another project. What I did was I had the yarn from my inklings. So I knew that if I finished either of those projects, what I could do is use the yarn that I had left over, whether and make like a pair of scrappy socks from the yarn that I was using in other projects, which was quite nice. I never got that far though. I just really worked on the inkling and then my vanilla socks out of the Grim Grinning Ghost colorway. And that was all I needed to take with me for my week away in Florida. And the socks were great for standing in lines and as we waited. And the inkling was great when I sat, just had a little bit of quiet time. One day I sat by the pool and worked on that for a bit. And it was also great for the plane ride. So took it easy that time. Last year when we went to Cape Cod, I took the On the Spice Market shawl. I also took a pair of socks. I took the Sock Society socks for last August, but they required too much concentration, so they didn't really get much attention. And then Isaac had his project with him, and I ended up stealing that from him most of the time when we were at restaurants because it was really easy to just work on. So this year I'm going to try and take something that is just an easy straight knit and then something else that I would like to work on, whether that's going to be a sweater or whether it will be a shawl. And if I have a sweater and if I have just a simple maybe knitting around, maybe I might take my sky map because it's just such an easy, it's easy, but then the alternating skeins isn't always as easy. I might take those two and then maybe a sock. And because I won't be driving the entire way, I probably will take three projects with me. And the thing I need to know and keep in mind is there are always yarn stores around. So if I run out of yarn, I can always go to a yarn store or I can use leftovers. If I happen to have leftovers in the projects that, you know, if I finish a project that I'm working on and I've got some leftover yarn, I can use that leftover yarn to make something. So I'm not going to be completely destitute. So I really, and then at the end of the holiday, I feel like I've accomplished something and I'm coming home with more finished things or almost finished things than skeins of yarn that I brought with me and they are all still unknit. So, and last year I did buy some yarn at the yarn store. So yes, there's never a shortage of yarn in my life. So I just have to try and be realistic. And that's how I'm hoping to go into this summer. I feel like I've rambled on for a long time, but I'm hoping to finish a couple of works in progress, namely my sweaters. I'm hoping to get some work done on my sky map as well, because that's just a nice, calm, easy knitting project. I will, of course, do a few test knits. So I've already started the Shawl Society for July. I'm hoping to also do the Sock Society for August and the Shawl Society for August as well. I have a test knit that I'm currently working on and I'm hoping to finish off at the end of the week. And I'm really hoping to do some selfish knitting. So one of the things that I really want to work on is a boxy sweater. And I think I'm going to do that as the Le Bien Aimé sweater knit along. And that starts today, June 30th. And I think I probably won't start today because I've got a couple of other things, but I will start in the next couple of days. And I am looking forward to just doing something for me, because a lot of times I'm doing test knits. And yes, sometimes they are things that are for me, but oftentimes I do gift them. But I'm looking forward to just some selfish knitting, and I'm really limiting the number of test knits that I'm going to do this summer. So I, as I said, I'm going to do the two shawl societies and the sock society. I have spoken with a couple of friends that I'm also going to do a couple of things for as well. So, but otherwise, I am looking forward to just having some quiet knitting time where I'm not taking on too many projects and putting too many expectations on myself, because that often goes completely awry. I have a very calm cat sitting on my lap. Tasha has now left me and has left me with a lot of fur on my lap. So I better make sure that I delint before I start knitting. Otherwise, my project is going to be covered in cat fur. Anyway, I would like to move on and just have a quick chat about the past week that has been happening in the community, the crafting community. And it has been an emotional one. It absolutely has, with all of the fallout from the discussions over racism and homophobia. And there are so many, you know, other issues that right now just feel like they are dividing our world. And sometimes it just feels so, so overwhelming. And oftentimes I feel like I am a little person and I don't know what I can do to help the state of the world. And I think we often all feel like that, that, you know, I'm just one person. And, you know, there are people who have much bigger voices and are more eloquent and are so much more articulate and can get those ideas out. And it's been a rough week. And one thing that has really stuck with me the entire week is in my office, I have a poster, and on that poster, it says, think. And I think that as we progress into this muddied world of social media and the feeling of the world going crazy around us, because I know that's how I'm feeling, I think it's really important to take that time to think about the things that we say, the things that we post, and the way that we behave. In my office, I have a poster, and sometimes I'll have someone who is having a conflict with someone else, and they'll come to speak with me. And I will refer to this poster, I'll point it out to them, and it says, think. And each of the letters in the word think means something. So the first one, T, means, is it true? Is what you are going to say truthful? Is it based on fact? Or is it something that you are hearing from someone that you have no idea they've reposted? It's sort of like that broken telephone game that you play when you were a child, and you know, it starts off as one thing and turns into something completely different. So making sure that what you're saying has some truth to it, some validity. Or is it based on a stereotype? And you know, stereotypes are very, very harmful. And they are not the truth. Stereotypes. The H. Is what you are going to say or post, is it going to be helpful to the situation? Or is it going to be harmful? And sometimes we need to step back and think about what we're wanting to say. You know, how will that impact the overall situation? The I, is it important? Does the information that you have or the information that you'd like to share, is it important? Is it going to make a positive difference? Because I'm hoping that when we are choosing our words, we are trying to make a positive difference in situations and in the world around us. So is it important? The N, is it necessary? Do you need to add in your two cents? Or is it something that, you know, maybe doesn't need to be shared? And the final one, the K, is it kind? sometimes we have to say things to people that we don't want to have to share with them. Maybe they, you know, we have to give them some criticism. Maybe we need to, you know, say something that is difficult. But we need to try to choose our words and make sure that what we are saying is said in a kind way. That whole, you know, if you can't say something nice, don't say anything at all. It's so much better. And you feel better about yourself too when, you know, as soon as you put out that nasty comment, you know, it's not a nice feeling that comes. So I think it's really important to stop and think before you either say something or put something out on social media. And I'm just sort of thinking about the movie You've Got Mail, and where Meg Ryan is saying about how she'd like to say something really, really nasty. And Tom Hanks says, actually, no, it's really not a nice feeling. You feel really bad afterwards. And I think that was that little bit about the kind, you know, comment that, you know, Mr. Nasty comes out. Mr. Nasty's never really all that nice, obviously, because he's Mr. Nasty. I think in this world, there's a lot more nicey people than there are nasty people. I know there are. And I think in our day-to-day life, we need to keep doing the little things that we know are helpful, are truthful, are important, and are necessary and kind. And I think if we can continue to do that and we can continue to work together, that we can hopefully bring about some healing. It's not going to be easy. It's never an easy topic to talk about. I think I've been recording this segment on its own for about 45 minutes. I'm not perfect. I will try my best. I'm not always as articulate as I would like to be. But one thing I do have is a hope that we can heal our community, and that we can find a common ground and an understanding. These are not easy conversations, for sure. And I am hoping, though, that we do continue the conversations and that, you know, we try our best to think, to be understanding, and to really be there for each other. I think that's probably one of the most important things, is to be there to support each other, to listen to each other, and to be kind to each other. And I think this has been a very heavy second half of Bits and Bobs. I thank you for bearing with me as I have chattered away. And I hope that we can think, we can be kind, and again, just be understanding of each other and our differences, and accepting of our differences. Thank you so much for joining me on the Comfy Red Couch this week. I hope that you have had a chance to sit down and relax. I hope that you have had a good amount of work that you've been able to do on your project of choice. I am wishing you a wonderful week ahead. I hope that it is filled with love. I hope that it is filled with kindness. And I hope that you are just feeling ready to continue the good work that you do in the world with the people around you. And I hope to see you next week on the Comfy Red Couch. Bye. I While I do try to be inclusive of many crafts, it is true I tend to default to knitting and knitting terminology a lot of the time, and I'm going to do that now. And when I was talking in bits and bobs about the word think, I realized that the word knit and think are very, very similar. The only difference is that knit is missing an H. And I was thinking about how when we are working on a project, whether it is knitting or whether it's sewing or crocheting or needle punching or whatever craft it is that we are doing, sometimes we make a mistake. And sometimes you look at that error and you've got to figure out what you need to do. Sometimes it is just moving on and keeping going, and you can live with that error. It's just a little blemish. Maybe it is, you know, you call it that design element. And if you're okay with it, you know it's not noticeable, you move on. And sometimes it's okay to do that. But sometimes it's not. And it can be very, very painful to have to deal with that mistake. And sometimes it means going back or tinking 5 rows, and sometimes those rows can be really long, like 575 stitches, and you've got to go back 5 rounds or rows to make that design perfect. I've done it. And I'm sure that in the future, I will do it again. I make mistakes. I'm not perfect. Sometimes it's easy, just you can drop down those 5 rows and fix that mistake. Whatever it is, I think that we can relate our crafting to the way we are in life. Sometimes we make mistakes, and sometimes we just have to say, yes, there's a mistake there, I'm gonna move on. Other times we go back and we have to painfully rectify that mistake. But hopefully in the end, we have a piece of fabric that we are happy to share with the world. And I think that's an important thing, to be able to know that, you know, we can relate our crafting to the way we present ourselves in the world. And sometimes there's going to be mistakes there. Other times, people are just going to see the beautiful fabric, and we don't have to point out those mistakes. But whatever you decide, whether you keep knitting forward or whether you tink back, you have to always do the best thing for you. Knitting and thinking, knitting and tinking, very, very similar concepts, aren't they?